And dinner is officially served.
I knew he was gonna do that. I knew he was gonna do that.
Let's get into some questions.
Have you ever met your hero? If so, were they what you expected?
Mine was. What about you?
Absolutely. She was amazing. It was Whitney.
Whitney.
Oh. It was Whitney. And I remember actually coming out of this hotel, and I remember her ex-husband, Bobby Brown, came up to myself and the girls, and he was like, oh my God, my wife loves y'all. And by the way, I'm just 16-year-old girl. And so I said, okay. So we go over, and she was in an interview with this woman, and it was for Out Magazine. I'll never forget it. And it was the first time we were mentioned with another artist in an article. And she stopped the interview, sang to us, talked to us, was like, oh, I'm gonna give y'all my number. If y'all need anything, just hit me up. I'm Auntie Whitney. I'm Auntie Whitney. You ever need anything, I got you. Wow. Just the sweetest woman, a woman of her word. You know what I mean? So it was.
Did you call her?
Of course we called her, for sure.
Met her a few times. She
called
was amazing.
Her and she called us and checked in with us, and that was just amazing. Same thing happened with Janet. Janet was the exact same way. Met Janet and
Jackson.
Yes, and when something was happening, I think it was we weren't supposed to travel because it was something crazy going on, like with airplanes and stuff, and she's like, I don't want you guys to fly today. I was like, okay, we won't fly today. Whatever you say. Yeah. So it's so awesome when you meet your hero. Who's your hero?
Bowie.
Mine
was Bowie. I met Bowie a few times, but the first time I ever physically saw Bowie, other than screaming at him in the street and the concerts, was in Australia. And I was in the airport leaving Sydney, and Bowie was in the first class lounge. And I was like, I'm not going up to him, because I wasn't sure if I was allowed. Anyway, years and years went by, and I never met him. And then eventually, I managed to have dinner with him in New York. And it was the most incredible thing. What was so funny about this dinner, there was this kid come up to the table and he said, hey, you guys, it's my girlfriend's birthday. Would you guys sing happy birthday? And of course, like an idiot, I was going to get up and go and sing happy birthday. And Bowie goes, no, I don't think that would be appropriate. No. And I sunk into my chair, like just thinking, oh my God, I nearly disobeyed my hero. And of course, when I thought about it, I was like, you can't. I'll stay with Bowie, just sing happy birthday to your 21-year-old girlfriend.
Right.
Like me on the other hand, I would have done it. But it was like, and he was everything I wanted, everything I wanted him to be.
Yes.
He was so charming. He was asking me ridiculous, just the funniest things. He was asking me about England, about tea and mad TV programs, like just rubbish that we used to watch on the telly.
Yeah.
Is that still going? And I was like, oh yeah, that's still going. It's still the same people.
That's so cool.
He was adorable, like literally adorable.